If you use Adobe After Effects or you're thinking of using it sometime in the future, today's video is really going to help you out because I have some free plugins and scripts that you can make great use of in Adobe After Effects. And we're going to start off today with something called the FX Console. And these are going to be linked down below, but do follow along so you understand exactly how these things work. And later in today's video, learn how you can get access to Skillshare Premium. Now, Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of different courses across a wide range of creative areas. These are things like logo designing, just graphic design in general, web design, photography, and so much more. So yeah, stay tuned to the very end of today's video to learn more. The FX Console is really, really handy, and you can download it for free on Mac or Windows. And this thing is going to help you search for effects in After Effects. So I'm just going to skip the installation process to save time in today's video. To show you how this thing works, just on a random composition, I'm going to generate a star here. Much like in Illustrator, when you want to have an anchor point central to your object, we can do that in After Effects here. So how does this FX Console actually work? So as long as you are clicked onto a layer, press Ctrl and Spacebar, and then this will appear. And from here, you can access effects very, very quickly. Instead of actually coming up here to the top right, we now have this console right on the screen. So for example, I can actually press Ctrl Spacebar and then just type in the fill, and voila, we have that fill. So yeah, this effects console is just a quicker way to access effects in Adobe After Effects. There are a few smaller features with this console, but the main appeal here is that you have access to those effects really, really easily by pressing Ctrl Spacebar. So the second addition in today's video is something called Butts Kappa, and it's made by the guys at Battleaxe. Now these guys make a lot of high-end plugins and scripts, and they're really, really useful and high quality. One of their most famous plugins is the rubber hose, which is relating to how arms and legs move in animations. But yeah, down on the bottom here, we do have some freebies. And there are some really neat ones here, and I haven't actually gone through all of them myself, but we're going to look at the Butt Kappa plugin today. You might want to take a look at these other ones as well in your own time. And also do remember that you're going to have to quit After Effects if you were installing something like a script or a plugin whilst it's open. So I'm going to go ahead and do that right now and be right back. So to demonstrate Butt Kappa, I'm going to just draw a random shape and then make sure it's got no fill, so it's just kind of a stroke path. Now when you're actually working on animation in After Effects, a lot of the time you do want the end of the stroke to be rounded off. And in Adobe Illustrator, we would call this a round cap. And normally, when you're working in After Effects, there's a long way around to actually do that, and it's by coming down into this path here. It just takes a long time to go through this process each and every time. But we can find the Butt Kappa plugin right here, and we can drag it and actually just position it into our workspace like so. And again, this is just going to speed up our workflow in After Effects, which is invaluable in the long run. So this rounded icon here will round off the ends of our stroke like so. It is really handy just to have it here off to one side when we're working, as opposed to coming into that path each and every single time. The next plugin today actually comes with After Effects, and you don't need to install anything. Come up to Window, and then create nulls from paths.jsx. If you click that, you're going to get this window over here. Now this plugin works with the points on a stroke path. And as you can see here, I've got four different points on the stroke. When you're trying to animate things like this, it can be very time consuming to fiddle around with each individual anchor point. But the create nulls from path makes things a lot easier, and I'm going to show you how right now. So if you highlight the stroke and then click points follow nulls, you would get this error message that comes up. Well, if you come into the shape layers and in the path down here, you need to highlight the path in this menu and then click the tab. This makes effectively four different nulls, and each point I showed you before will follow these nulls. If I click the shape layer, you will see it's made the effects up here at the top, And if I move them like this, it actually alters in real time. And you can set keyframes just like normal. So I press P to drop down a position, and then just move it forward 2 seconds on my timeline. Drag this null over to the left. Now that null will follow that. It gives you more control and it does maybe make the timeline a bit more busy, but it's very, very handy for complex animations. It's very intuitive. So if you're involved with very technical animation, it's going to be very, very useful. We also have null follows points, which essentially is just the inverse. You can see my 4 nulls are here. They're all on the points. So if I go into the path now and I move this one down here, and then if I click up, you will see that the null always follows that path. And so you can do some pretty complicated animations with this. It does give you more flexibility on how you animate things in After Effects. And finally, with this plugin, the trace path creates a null from one part of your path to the other. So make sure you've actually highlighted the path, then click trace path, and this null has appeared on the line. And what it's doing is it's actually starting from the left and it's continuing all the way over to the right. What you could do is you could put a car or something on top of this, and then you could say animate the car that follows this path as a kind of a road. That's just one way you could use this. There are many ways to do that, but this is one of the most time-saving methods of doing it. The fourth script in today's video, guys, is called Dojo Ease Script. So you need to scroll down and find this link here. And just like you always do with scripts and plugins, you need to put this into the program files of After Effects. And when you finally open up After Effects once more, we do have this window here of the Dojo Ease script. If you've used After Effects for any length of time, you will know that often animation can just look pretty boring. So an example here, just moving this circle from left to right in an orderly, steadily fashion, it just looks pretty boring. And you're probably going to want to bring this animation to life. So if I highlight all of my keyframes on this animation, and then I come over to the Dojo Ease plugin, you will notice I have these options here in this drop-down menu. What they do is they change the Easy Ease graph meter, which will dictate how your animation actually moves in a fluid fashion. And one I use quite a lot is the Medium Ease, and let's have a look at how that plays out now. And there we go, it kind of starts off slow, speeds up, and then finishes slow. Which is a lot better than just having a plain old boring animation. Again, this is another time saver that stops us having to come into the graph editor over and over again. We just do things with one click of a button. You could go more aggressive and use a strong ease, and you can see in the graph editor in real time how it affects things. You can come into the settings menu and do more detailed, in-depth, more involved adjustments to every single thing you do. But also a really cool one is the overshoot effect. So let's go back and highlight the keyframes and then give that a try. If you press Control click on your keyframes, it will return them back to normal keyframes. The overshoot adds a little bounce or wiggle at the end of the animation, which just brings it to life that much more. But yeah, these were the plugins that will save you time, and they're all free, remember, they're not something that you're gonna pay for. If you can save time for free in After Effects, well, I think that's a win. So yeah, the sponsor of today's video is Skillshare. And Skillshare is an online learning community with millions of different users taking thousands of different classes. Now you can actually learn new skills or nurture existing passions, or you might even discover a hidden talent that you might have. Now I'm actually currently taking a course by Gustavo Torres, and I'm brushing up on my skills even though my routine is pretty jam-packed throughout each day. Now Skillshare normally costs just less than $10 per month, but the first 1,000 people who click the link down below today and sign up to Skillshare will be granted a free trial to Skillshare Premium. So yeah, click the link down below and sign up to Skillshare and discover new skills today. But yeah, if you want to learn more about graphic design or After Effects, do click a video on screen. And until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.